You could call this Sweetest Day in Chicago. For Tuesday is the birthday of the greatest player in the history of the Chicago Bears, and to many, the entire National Football League. That's Walter Payton, who was born on July 25th, 1954 in Columbia, Mississippi. He would have been 69 years old on Tuesday. And where do we begin when it comes to the running back who helped turn a struggling franchise into an NFL power when he arrived as a fifth overall pick in the 1975 NFL draft after a successful career at Jackson State? He was a 9-time Pro Bowl selection, 5-time NFL first-team All-Pro, and made the second team twice. Payton won the 1977 NFL MVP when he rushed for 1,852 yards in 14 games. He was also named the Offensive Player of the Year in 1977 and the Man of the Year. In 1984, he broke Jim Brown's all-time rushing record and would finish his career with 16,726 yards on the ground. Payton helped the Bears to 6 playoff appearances, 2 NFC Championship games, and the Super Bowl XX title during the memorable 1985 season. He retired in 1987 and remained in the public eye until 1999, when he revealed his bile duct cancer diagnosis. Payton died November 1, 1999, at the age of 45. Walter was quoted many times in his very public life in Chicago, but here's one that always stands out. It came right after his final game, January 10, 1988, after a playoff loss to Washington at Soldier Field.
The last 13 years, for me, they've been a lot of good moments, a lot of bad moments. You know, there have been some times when you wanted to quit, some times when you couldn't see quit in sight. But I think overall, it's been a lot of fun.
For him and those here in Chicago who watched, here's just a few major achievements for Payton. He's still second in rushing yardage in NFL history behind Smith. Walter's fifth in rushing touchdowns in NFL history with 110. And Payton still leads the Bears with most receptions in franchise history with 492. Walter was inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 1993, and the NFL's Man of the Year Award, which he won in 1977, was named in his honor after his death in 1999. More on Walter in the story below or at WGNTV.com. For this edition of the 9-Yard Line, I'm Larry Hawley, WGN News Now.